Alright, hey guys, this is Steve Budd. This is Budcast episode 5, I think now. I'm here with my buddy Black Bud again.
Hey dude.
And today we got a game between Apothecary on the bottom of Quest Heresy, and we got Holyhammer xHoLyHammerx on the top, playing as Warboss.
Yeah, and Apothecary is actually RoseN in disguise.
RoseN.
So, old school SM player. Very, very good. So, this is a very nice match between two high tier players. So, I'm excited to see how it plays out. Very importantly, though, RoseN has an awesome color scheme.
It's baby blue.
I mean,
blue,
check
man.
Out this baby blue.
It's good. It's all good. Alright, so, let's get the show on the road. I'm at 5 seconds. Let's start in 3, 2, 1, go. Alright, so yeah, Warboss versus APO, man. What are your initial thoughts?
Scouts ready. I'm curious to see how RoseN approaches this matchup after the Apoth nerfs. Because it used to be you just try and steamroll things with APO heal, but now that that's been tiled down, I'm interested to see how these opening phases go. And we've got a recon Warboss coming out here.
Yeah, I was just going to comment. Like, yeah, I don't know what he's doing. Usually you cap with him. He can't really do much against Space Marine right off the bat. There's no melee squads to go.
He's trying to catch Scout.
Yeah.
But not finding any, he just starts capping. Yeah, interesting. I don't think that's going to pay off for him at all.
It's not. Not at all.
I mean, I understand the logic behind it, but you can already see how the capping of his second and third points is delayed by that Warboss running around. And the Warboss has already gotten like a third of his HP taken down for no damage at all.
Alright, so HoLyHammerx is going shoot a build, looks like. Kind of just standard orc. Oh, but he has the third Slugga. So what do you think, like, two Sluggas against this APO? I think it's going to be really good, especially if he goes ASM to go with the APO.
Yeah, for sure. You really do want that melee. Interestingly enough, we see RoseN foregoing power. So not going quick ASM, but it looks like, yeah, there it is, second attack squad. And the Warboss is forced off without doing anything.
Yeah, I mean,
also of note,
kind of like tied him up for a second, but he didn't really do anything with his shooters while they were tied up.
Yeah, and RoseN was using his APO in a range stance there to keep him out of the line of fire of shooters and just keeping him behind green cover. Awesome move.
Nice shotguns on the scouts.
Yep, and the APO and attacks are just going to charge down and melee these two shooters.
Yeah, HoLyHammerx definitely has to focus out that Apothecary. He really has a chance with those shooters. His Apothecary doesn't have very much health, and having two big shooter squads is just going to, like, snipe him out, like, instantly. So if he can ever do that, he needs to.
Yeah. Plus, when he's not forcing off the APO, you can already see how these attacks basically have ridiculous staying power, and they're just not going to retreat until that APO's gone.
Yeah, man, the kind of just passive hot around the Apothecary is just so good.
Yeah. And we've got Storm Boys coming down for HoLyHammerx, which should be pretty good against this ranged build from RoseN.
Yeah, I mean, just even more melee. He's got one scout squad to kind of shotgun blast, but against two Sluggas and a Storm Boy, it's going to get real difficult for him soon if he doesn't do something to really stop it.
Yeah. And interestingly enough, not a single node... Oh, there goes the first node, and Holyhammer makes me a liar. But anyways, no power was down for a while there. And importantly, that means no big Shootas yet,
yeah,
or any upgrade.
It's strange. Apothecary is... I guess he's saving up for ASMs? Yeah, there he goes.
Oh, there you go.
He has a lot of flow right now. I would know why he's doing that instead of buying power, but yeah, he's going ASMs, which I think is perfect. I mean, with these two tacks, he has to kind of just use the ASM super defensively, just to really stop all this melee from doing crazy damage.
Yeah.
I mean, like, the orc is just gonna totally steamroll this with just like, if they just A moves together, you know, in the middle or something. But RoseN, if he uses his abilities right, like just jump on the Assault Space Marines and the Shotgun Blast, then he'll definitely win. And I guess heal as well.
Yeah, and I'm loving how Holyhammer is just spreading out and capping up this entire map right now.
I mean, he has a lot of squads, so he needs to do that.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. These ASMs are charging in and getting met by a bunch of firepower. Nice shotgun blast on the Storm.
Yeah, now just with his Apothecary Death Blob. Ooh, he uses Hard Boys there. Oh, and he's got the gun on the War Boss.
Yeah.
I guess he's just going to try and use it in engagements to kind of take out the Apothecary from doing anything.
And that's a great call, because if the Apothecary is on his ass, then he's not healing. And messing up that calculus for the SM player can really, really lead to some crucial model losses on squads like Pax and ASM.
Exactly, yeah. And especially, like, when these two are actually going to have, like, a big engagement with all their forces, it's just going to come down to, like, really, really small things that makes the, like, one or the other win. It's going to be that, that Apothecary knocked over, he couldn't heal. Because if he can't heal, he's going to, like, lose his ASMs to three melee squads, man. They're going to go down.
Yeah. Something, speaking of small things, I'm curious about Holyhammer's control of his squads right now. He's bleeding models kind of unnecessarily. Like, we just saw a Slugga squad retreat after going alone into all of Rosen's forces, and we see these Storm Boys just jumping in with no follow-up planned on Holyhammer's part.
Yeah, he definitely,
those losses,
like,
really do
against
add up.
This Apothecary, like, just kind of blobbing kind of tactic here by RoseN, he's got to use all of his units together. Unless he can get RoseN to split his, which I don't think he's going to do, especially not on this map. It's too easy to keep everything together.
Yeah, he's got to do that, or he's got to split and cap around RoseN while holding his gen farm.
Yeah, but I don't. It's so hard on this map to do that, man.
Yeah, that's so true. So true. If it was on, ooh, and Warboss goes down. Got really.
Oh hey,
late retreat. Out
I'm let's do a time check. I'm at 641, 2, 643, 4, 5, 6, 7.
And I am back up with.
All right, yeah. So.
No problem.
Yeah,
I'll just
these
keep that
Sluggas
in mind
and the Storm
check.
Boy. Need to stick together, especially, you know, first these ASMs and attacks. Finally, we have tier 2 coming out for Holy. Our Apothecary
has gained a level. Yep, yep. But he's really, really pushed back here. The Apothecary has this death ball going on right now with this ranged critical mass of attacks.
Yeah, I mean,
and we've got a bit of hammer rage.
When your opponent is actually, like, killing your gens on this map, it means that you're definitely doing something wrong. It's very rare for a player to actually get off with gen harass on this map, since it's so easily defended.
Yeah. Ooh, and we've got Use Your Choppas down on these Sluggas. Taking these ASMs, but...
Gets a model. Maybe another one, too.
Got some model, maybe two. No. Shotgun Blast. No shotgun blast.
So what do you think about no upgrades on the Apothecary yet?
I think that's pretty fair. A lot of the APO's good upgrades come in tier 2, and it all depends on how RoseN ends up wanting to use him. He's investing a lot into his army composition right now, rather than decking out his hero, which is very valid and paying off for him very, very well. He's just, all he needs that APO for is for that healing aura and for a heal here and there to keep his squads on the field.
Yeah, I was particularly thinking of the one, I forget what it's called, the tier 1 upgrade where he, where his heal knocks back, like, everything around him. Additional units
have become available. Yeah, that would be great
it
against
these melee
squads.
It would be, but I guess, he's not getting it kind of for a reason, because Holyhammer isn't kind of attacking with everything at once, so he hasn't really needed to use it, to be honest. Like just Storm Boy's all by himself, not a big deal, just jump on him.
Just like that.
Yep. Now we have
and
a
we've
truck.
Got the Power Axe coming up on the APO. Now it looks like he's about to get a little feisty with it. No more sitting on the back lines there.
Now, what do you think about the War Truck versus Weird Boy? I kind of would have preferred Weird Boy at this point.
Yeah, Holyhammer doesn't really have the economy to support a War Truck, like, endless green
he
tide.
Couldn't, he couldn't, yeah, really reinforce all of his units, so... Yeah, the Weird Boy, it would have allowed him to kind of just follow the attack blob, and he could Warp Vomit on the only melee squad he has, which is the ASM, so I think it would have been, like perfect to get a Weird Boy, and these scouts are going down over here on the right. That's gonna really hurt RoseN.
Yeah, he was really depending on that for map control.
Yeah, and see, look, Sluggas and the Storm Boys, like he's using his units together, and he's forcing his opponent to retreat and like take losses. Man.
Yeah,
it's what he needs to be doing.
Yeah, and the big plus of that War Truck is being able to drive up past that range firepower and just unload melee squads in his favor. However, there is going to be a timer on that kind of strategy. We already see one missile launcher on the TAC Marines.
We got Meltus on the
and Melta Bomb. Yeah, so that was a one-trick pony
now,
thing that
notice,
really shouldn't be happening.
Now notice Holyhammer's choice on these shooters. They're vanilla right now. He hasn't upgraded big shooters, no knobs. Now do you think he's doing that on purpose just to kind of like be like... You know, don't hate me for using these OP shooters, or do you think he's just doing that like for a specific like strategy reason?
I mean, if he's really prioritizing that melee, he might just be trying to save the resources.
Yeah, I mean, he is like I would say he saved a lot of power for sure. I mean, he did have the. Called the gun on the war boss pretty early, so I guess it was kind of worth it.
Yeah, but at the same time, you just saw... Ooh, yeah, very nice move. You just saw two shooter squads focus firing into APO, who, being one of the most weak heroes in the game, didn't even blink an eye at it.
Yeah.
So...
Even the APO's gonna go down here in a second if he turns around with these Sluggas.
Yeah. But he does have
Sluggas.
Purification
oh
rights.
Oh, Angels of Death.
Slugapalooza.
Slugapalooza.
Yeah, nice pop of Angels of Death there, really turning the tide of that battle.
Yeah, he
Holy Hammer can't stay in this, although he is being greedy and doing.
Yeah, I mean, these shooters are pretty much worthless besides capping. Maybe like fodder or something. Yeah, we have a Devastator.
Pea shooters and cannon fodder. How do you feel about this Devastator?
I think it's fine as long as he keeps it really, really far back and he baits the jump on his tacks. I think it'll work perfect. He has no Shruk to kind of flank it anymore, so it's going to work. Armor of the Apothecarian, too.
Yeah, that's going to be great.
His blob is
going to
get even stronger.
Yeah, there's no way Holyhammer's going to be able to push that off.
I mean,
one thing to say in
Holyhammer's
favor,
man.
Though.
It'd be perfect against this.
Yeah, that would be great. Holyhammer is doing a great job of keeping the map cap.
Watch out.
And keeping that resource advantage. Ooh, nice merciless strike.
Although it really wasn't worth it. do anything with that.
Yeah, right. But it sure looked pretty.
It looked amazing.
Pew pew. Love these graphics. So, I feel like the natural follow-up here for RoseN is to get a librarian. Just the veil of time that dev and support his troops, which he then proves me to be a liar and.
Hey, you're no liar, man. It's your opinion.
Theory crafting speculated that.
He should have gone librarian. Why'd he win Razorback instead?
Which is also a great call because Holyhammer can't really afford AT right now, or AV.
Yeah. I mean, he does get the Weird Boy, but it's not anywhere as good as Tank Busters for jumping on that. For balling it, I mean.
Oh, yeah.
There's Ard Boys again on the Sluggers. And see, there we
and
go.
And he's
there's
knocking back that ape out.
It's gonna, yeah.
Well, that was anticlimactic.
Yeah, but these Sluggers still have a chance. Oh, he used Arming the Prothecarian, that's why. He's gonna lose
the Apo. Yeah, but the Apo's gonna go down. Yeah, nice snipe.
He's got even more Sluggers, but yeah, and, this Razorback is really gonna put a wrench. Put a razor in his back.
Oh, you're so punny. And RoseN doesn't have enough red to revive his Apo right now, so that actually was a very valuable snipe on Holy's part.
Yeah, VP's
nice.
Still really
Oh, and he's gonna try.
I mean, if he can get this Razor back, maybe, or if he can get another pick, this game is still like anyone.
And Holyhammer's attack grounding with that. Weird Boy. Oh! Oh!
So close. Those ASMs are in trouble too. We might lose them all. Yeah, the Razorback gets away.
Oh! So close.
Oh, Warboss goes down, just runs straight into those devs.
Yeah, it seems like Holyhammer just... Yeah, that was great attack ground micro from Holyhammer. It's a pity it didn't pay off with a Razorback kill, but yeah. Still.
Still anyone's game.
It's forcing RoseN to replace those scouts.
Both got hero picks.
Before that.
Only thing I'm concerned about really is Holyhammer doesn't have any power, but I guess he doesn't really need it. He has a bunch saved up. 128.
Wait, Steve. Orcs can play without quick teching to tier 3.
Hey, man. I know, it's insane. Look at these shooter boys doing pretty good damage there against those tacks.
Oh, yeah. I think I'll take a nap and come back, and then maybe they'll be at half health.
Nice jump with the assault squad there. Backing up his
and
death.
One squad of tacks drives off, both shoot a squad.
We are suffering heavy losses. The chapter stands. And does he have suicide? No, he doesn't. I usually always get suicide. It, what do you call it? Bomber Boy? I guess the correct name for it?
Yeah, Bomber Boy.
It actually also increases the range of jump by a shitload. So it's actually pretty practical, even if you don't use the suicide ability.
And it's always good to have that option to try and get a retreating squad.
Yeah, especially with, I think against Space Marine, it could really turn it around. Because, I mean, those Assault Space Marines could get in trouble and be down to, like, one model or, like, two models. And that explosion, you know, will help the Sluggers chasing them down to actually finish the squad.
Yeah.
He comes out with a truck again. Which, I mean, he doesn't really have very many options.
I think that's a good call.
To be honest, he already has Weird Boy now. He has all of his squads pretty much decked. So yeah, he's just gotta use his units now. The orcs are taking one of our strategic. It's coming down to kind of placement of units. You call that micro.
Yeah. Positional play.
Yeah, but I mean, look at Holyhammer right now. He's kind of still getting map control, even though his opponent has the middle.
Yeah, he's going for this nice little enveloping play here. RoseN's really staked his claim on the middle, so Holy's doing a great job of just maneuvering around that.
And especially, it's going to be good against this Devastator, but I mean, I guess he retreated this other Slugosaur. He can't come behind. But it doesn't matter, because Weird Boy's there. Really needs to get that warp... Oh! Really need to get that good warp bomb on the Slugosaur's going on the Dev.
Yes.
Yeah. Just throw the Weird Boy in the truck real quick.
Meanwhile, we've got the Storm Boys with Use Your Choppas.
Bringing his truck around to reinforce it, but he's gonna lose the APO.
Oh! Got him.
Slug is going down over here, too. Oh, no.
Yeah, and he has no wreck to reinforce.
This is getting
he's gotta
nuts.
Get out of there. He's gotta get out of there. Or he doesn't have to get out of there.
Just everyone put everything in your transport.
Party the trans. But in all seriousness, that was great micro on Holyhammer's part to get those squads away. Man.
Like they,
oh,
they
I didn't
both,
even see RoseN high though.
Didn't mass retreat like a lot of players would. They're getting the most out of all their units right now.
Yeah. And for that matter, I feel like actually RoseN got the better end of that.
Yeah,
besides
you know,
the hero
death. I think you might be right. He has a lot more wreck float right now, and I think that's precisely what, like, the reason. That fight right there just bled Holyhammer a lot.
Yeah.
And now he's going back with his blob again. And yeah, Holyhammer isn't going to have really any option besides to retreat right now. And not having any dedicated AV is going to really put Holyhammer in a tough spot. Because, like,
his
Apothecary can just put everything in his Razorback and kind of just, like, dance around with it, while Holyhammer can't do the same thing because he has the Missile Attack and he has the Meltas.
Plus, his squads don't have the staying power that SM squads do.
Yeah.
So while he's dancing around, he's hemorrhaging models left and right. And there's a reason why he has almost no resources right now.
Who's getting over there? Big brains.
Such a fun upgrade.
It's my favorite thing to do now, Zork. Just throw all my units everywhere.
You and screwing around with sub-commanders, like, it's like a little fascination of yours. It would be great to see maybe a claw out of,
Yeah, you know, I think
Holy
he needs
Hammer
to get it. Something to kind of deal with his Razorback, besides just Sluggers attacking it. I mean, yeah, this Weird Boy was doing a good job, damaging it before with ground attack, but it's not gonna really work later on when he needs to use it for vomiting and attacking the Devastating instead of. Ooh, he's coming out with a Dreadnought! Yeah.
And to take a quick note of BPs, it's 302 to 90 right now.
Yeah.
So Holyhammer is a great position there.
But
however,
I think this Dreadnought is really gonna do it for Holyhammer.
Yeah, that truck's gonna go down. Soon.
The truck's gonna go down.
Chases.
As soon as the Dreadnought comes out, he has nothing to counter it.
Yeah. And he's trying to trade with an APO, as he's been all game, and it's just not cost effective.
Scouts might go down. Scouts go down. APO's about to go down. Truck's about to go down. Another tax about to go down.
And the Sluggers are going
ground
to attack to kill the Razorback.
Ground attacking the Razorback.
Oh!
Almost. See, if he had, if he like somehow saves up the wreck to get Tank Busters, that thing would have been dead a while ago.
Yeah.
Because now he's got to deal with two vehicles, and he doesn't have the capability to do that. This Dredd is just gonna walk
no,
all over.
No, he has
everything.
No AV, and no money.
I mean, the only thing I can see him doing is getting the claw. And ganking something with it. But that's about it. Otherwise, it's pretty much game as soon as RoseN just balls up all of his units and throws a Dreadnought at him. Yeah, like right now, he's not even scared.
Yeah,
he just balls
oh,
deep
dear
in
God.
The
Dreadnought. Oh!
Oh, and there's a GG.
Damn, that. Yeah.
Wow, that was a really good match. It was so...
Yeah, I gotta agree. That was really well played.
Yeah, man. Just that... Well, it was like a string of engagements here in mid where it was so even, but Holyhammer just couldn't get, like, more of a wreck advantage than Apothecary did.
Yeah. And one of the things with Apothecary, as RoseN was adding those upgrades and squads leveling over time, is that Holyhammer's strategy of kind of like green tiding RoseN to death was getting less and less cost effective as the game went on. So even though he was winning fights, he was actually losing it in the economic battle. And you actually saw that out in him not even being able to afford an AV squad to kill a freaking Razorback.
Yeah, I mean, if he could have maybe just held out, maybe just played the map control game a little longer, just to get that Razor, to get the tank busters, he would have got that Razorback a while ago. I mean, he was already ground targeting it almost to death and beating it up with, like, sluggers. Like, that one squad would have made it, like, would have definitely killed that Razorback. And he would have had something to actually, like, deal with the Dreadnought. Or at least some time, you know? Some time to, like, regain map control, like, just totally dominate VPs at that point, because he only had, like, 90 left to get.
Yeah, there was a possibility for Holyhammer to get that Razorback snipe and go for the VP blitz. But because RoseN was able to bleed Holyhammer so much and keep those vehicles alive, there was nothing really Holyhammer could do at a certain point.
Yeah.
And, I mean, we saw a little banter about SM Eco, but... The real matter is that his orcs were just bleeding everywhere.
Yeah, but I mean, to be honest, I don't know. Holyhammer could have still came back with this game, maybe if he just made RoseN split all of his units. I mean, maybe he could have done it a little easier before the Dreadnought came out, but if he just, like, threw squads at every VP and just kind of played that game, like, RoseN's forces were so strong because he could keep them together. If he was forced to split... It wouldn't have been that way, and it just put, like, two sluggers on one point, and it would have been, like, impossible to push them off. So, I don't know, this game could have gone the other way, like, really easily, if maybe Holy kind of did a little different of a strategy here at the end.
Yeah, and that's a telling sign of a great game between two great players.
Yeah, man, this is one of my favorite games so far that we've done. I really liked it, I hope you guys liked it. Yeah, so I think that's gonna do it for Budcast episode 5. I think this is 5 now. Yeah, thanks for watching, guys. This is Steve Bud. This is my buddy Black again.
See y'all later.
Yeah. Budcast out. Bud.